Yeah, so that's where the sort of two separate types of criticism of Section 230, I think, make the debate very difficult. So we have the criticism that I think Speaker Pelosi and I think a lot of Democrats have raised that there's not enough moderation. Now, Speaker Pelosi had a video posted of her that was edited to make it look like she was incapacitated, and it wasn't proper. Some would argue it wasn't properly dealt with, and that it stayed up. So that's one set of arguments. The other set, which is coming from some conservative members of Congress and conservative groups, is that there's too much moderation, and that there's not, I guess the term they would use is neutrality, and that their argument is that Section 230 requires neutrality or is premised on neutrality. One of the reasons I think the history is important is because it's actually premised on not having neutrality, on giving the platforms the tools to be able to have that breathing room to decide what is proper. And I think what you're talking about with some of these sort of fringe speech, some people, I think there are some things that are clearly bad, and so I mean there's illegal, there's criminal content, for example. But when you're talking about some sort of political speech, there could be things that some might argue is hate speech or could incite violence, while others might say, no, that's legitimate political speech. And that's why it's so difficult. And that's why Section 230 is so important, because it gives the platforms the ability to make those really tough decisions. And we're not talking about like three or four decisions a day. We're talking about just this vast amount of content that's coming in all the time. And that's where I see the real challenge, is distinguishing between that. And I don't think there's an easy way to do it.